What's up, YouTube? It is your boy JB, and we are here today with the review for The Real Housewives of Beverly Hills, you guys. Sorry that I didn't get the video to you guys yesterday. I was in the process of moving. So, we are here today to discuss Real Housewives of Beverly Hills, Season 11, Episode 5, and the episode was titled The Divided States of Erica. All right, you guys. So, before we actually get into this video, you guys can hear me. I really do. The air is running. Like I said, it's hot here in Texas. My car is reading 102 degrees right about now. So, yeah, can't, you know, deal with that too long. So, we're going to do a video. We're going to talk about the hustler and the housewife. And then we'll talk about this episode as well. But like I said, I hope you guys can hear me. I know you guys are kind of shaking. We might be shaking. I'm sorry, you guys. But yeah, without further ado, and actually before we get into this review, if you guys are watching this video or any other video on the channel and you're not already subscribed, why are we still going out on dates with one another and you don't pay for the bill? So let's go ahead and talk about this show, shall we? Alright, you guys, so before we get into the episode, I want to talk about The Housewife and the Hustler that premiered on Hulu. It was, what, Monday when it came out? It was like the 14th or something like that. So I definitely watched The Housewife and The Hustler. And with that one, the story between Tom and Erica is a lot worse than what I initially thought it was. I thought it was just about those kids with the plane crash, but it was so much deeper than that. Now, the one thing that I was so thoroughly confused about is why in the hell did they get Danielle Staub to come and talk? Danielle, someone who says she doesn't know Erica, but she's worked with her on Watch What Happens Live, and from what she saw, she wasn't too impressed. Danielle, I'm not impressed with you. That wig was terrible. That makeup was horrible. Your lips, girl, stop. So yeah, Danielle wasn't too pleased with it. I'm like, okay, whatever. So yeah, Housewife and the Hustler. Allegedly, Tom has been doing this stuff for like, what, 30 plus years or so? No, 40 years. And it's interesting that if Tom was doing all this stuff that he's alleged to have done, I wonder why in the hell did he let, you know, well, he didn't let Erica. Why was he okay with being on the, you know, why was he okay with Erica being on Real Housewives of Beverly Hills and himself then being seen on Real Housewives of Beverly Hills? It just doesn't make a lot of sense to me. Being completely honest, it makes no sense whatsoever why he felt that way. Don't get it. But so yeah, the first person that they were talking about is a guy named Joe. Joe's story was really sad. What was it, like a pipeline that had burst and incinerated that whole neighborhood? I think Joe is like the only person that survived. His girlfriend, her body was found in the shed days later, dead. Like, how do you prey on people who are going through horrific, life-changing events? I don't get it. And then you take their money, and then you sit there and say, oh, we're gonna have to put this in a trust. You know, that's just too much money. Let me make that decision for myself. If I wanna put this money up, if I want to blow through all this money, let me blow through. If I don't, either way it go, it's my money. Thank you for, you know, going to bat for me in court. You know, we'll pay your legal fees. But other than that, the hell? And then, you know, Joe's mother, his best friend, she's the one that actually got them with Tom. And her son died in a motorcycle accident. And he won a settlement for her. I'm like, and then, like I said, the cycle of events started up again. I'm like, yeah, ain't no way in hell I would, ooh. I still don't get why he went on TV with doing this show. Like, you're showcasing some, you're putting, with Beverly, especially with the Beverly Hills Housewives, they always show how much things cost when those women go shopping and they buy it. And then you got these victims that are broke and penniless. Joe can't even afford his, you know, what needs to be done to him. Yeah, Tom. Yeah, it's just a lot. It's a lot with that. Like, when it comes to Erica, I think Erica knew some of what Tom was doing, but I don't think she knew 100% of what Tom was doing. But I definitely think she knew something. Like, you can't tell me any otherwise. Let me know what you guys think. The Housewife and the Hustler. It's on Hulu. It's streaming on Hulu currently. Yeah, it was terrible. But let's go ahead and get into this review. I don't want to go too long with this, okay? So let's go ahead and talk about Real Housewives of Beverly Hills. Alright, you guys, so the episode, it started up with Erica's, go figure. So with Erica, she's like, you know, she was talking about she can't explain this divorce. I bet you can't explain this divorce. We'll piggyback to this because I'm going to mention something that Garcelle's going to mention later in the episode. But I'm like, I bet you can't. So the episode, they were having a party, but it went back 3 days earlier. So, let's talk about Kyle. So Kyle is getting ready to have an election party. So everyone is going to come to the election party with the exception of Erica and Garcelle. So we see all the ladies as they're heading to the party that's coming. So Sutton's coming, Crystal's coming, Sutton, Crystal, Rena, and I think that's it. And Kathy. No, was Kathy there? Yeah. No? Was Kathy at that party? Yes, she was. So it's everyone with the exception of Garcelle and so, we saw Kyle. She was talking to Maurizio, and she was telling Maurizio that, you know, she and Dorit had gotten into it with one another when they were on their way back from Lake Tahoe. So, what happened is Dorit was having a conversation with Crystal, and Kyle decided to butt her ass into the conversation, and Dorit told her not so many words, butt the fuck out. Like, get out of my business, basically. So Kyle felt some type of way about that. She said that Dorit yelled at her. I'm like, girl, have you never been yelled at before? Like, is that what it is? You've never been yelled at in your life? Okay. So we also see, as Crystal's heading to the party. So Crystal and Robert, you know, talking about how she feels. And she was talking about Sutton. Honestly, I'm still on Crystal's side when it comes to the whole Sutton situation, so it's not going to change over here. So I was trying to, now when I saw, so the theme of the party was election, so they all have to come in patriotic wear. I don't know what patriotic look Dorit was going for. Maybe she was going for Scottish, I don't know. Sutton, I don't know what that was you had on, looked like a muumuu. So then they talk about Erica, and at this point, they haven't really heard from Erica at this point, but they're not surprised. So then we talk about Sutton and Crystal. So Sutton and Crystal, they're good. So then Crystal tells us that, you know, after that trip in Lake Tahoe, she lost about 5 pounds. They're like, oh, that's good. She's like, no, that's not really good. She says, because I'm someone who has battled with bulimia. And she, you know, she'll discuss her story later in the episode with Rob about her bulimia. And, you know, Kathy was like, you know, Sutton, say thank you. I'm like, Sutton, don't say thank you. Please don't say thank you. So, but she's like, I'm not going to be to blame for her eating problem, her eating disorder or whatever. Sutton, nobody was placing blame on her. She was just saying that she just had a difficult time eating. She wasn't blaming you. Like, that situation could have been just as stressful to her that she just, you know, forgot to eat. There were a culmination of things that could have happened. It didn't have to be because of you. But whatever, so go off, her friend. So then we see Kyle and Dorit. They go and have a conversation with each other. And they won't talk, they're talking about what happened on the plane. And, you know, Kyle feels that with Dorit, that if it were any other ladies, that Dorit wouldn't have done that. And I was like, I guess if you want to say so, I don't know. Now, I would have been great in this situation. Because Kyle, like, do you want? Are you my friend? Yes. If we want to make this friendship work, you don't ever talk to me that way again. And I was like, huh? And y'all know, I love me some Kyle. But in that instance, I would have did exactly what Dorit did. I would be like, you know what, Kyle? As your friend, I'm going to, you know, remove myself from the situation before I say something to you that you might not like. So let me get up and exit stage left. And that's exactly what Dorit did. And now Kyle feels some type of way. I'm like, but you should have said nothing to her. Like, you literally just sat there and told her, if you're my friend, don't talk to me that way again. Like, girl, who are you to have a conversation with me like that? Absolutely not. It won't happen. Like, I'm not going to deal with it. The hell? Yeah, Kyle, you had it. You had that situation all the way tore up. But let's move on, you guys. Alright, guys, next let's talk about Dorit. So, we saw Dorit as she was getting ready for the party. And Dorit was talking to PK, who still for the life of me annoys the crap out of me. So Dorit gave her side of what happened in the conversation. So what Dorit says happened is, like she said, they were on their way back from Lake Tahoe and she was having a conversation with Crystal. Now she never said what the conversation with Crystal was about, but she just said that she and Crystal were having a conversation with one another and that Kyle turned around and inserted herself in the conversation. Now, Kyle, here's my thing. Here's the thing with that. If we're having a private conversation, yes, you might be able to hear what we're saying, but unless I ask for your input, like, hey, Kyle, what do you feel about such and such? Or, hey, Kyle, do you agree with what I said? Or, hey, Kyle, are you on Crystal's side? Or, hey, Kyle, this. Or, hey, Kyle, that. Like, if I ask for your input, then give it to me. But if I don't ask for your input, I don't want it. Like, are you serious? Mind your business, Kyle. Like, literally, mind your business. And then Kyle had the audacity to cry when Dorit basically told her, mind your business. I'm like, girl, here go these white woman tears. You crying for no reason. Like, are you serious? All Dorit said was, Kyle, let me finish a thought, please and thank you. And that was it. So Kyle was being melodramatic. Ow, I bit my tongue. Kyle was just being melodramatic at that point. Like, let's call a spade a spade. Kyle was being melodramatic as hell. Girl, if I was Dorit, I wouldn't even apologize. I'm like, Kyle, I was having a conversation with Crystal. You chimed into the conversation. And what did you expect me to do? Like, I didn't get to finish what I was saying before you jumped into the conversation. And there are some people in the car right over here from me that are looking at me while I'm doing this review. But, yeah, like, I would have told Kyle, in not so many terms, go to hell. Period. Let's move on. All right, you guys, I think I'm going to talk about Crystal next, and then we'll go into Renna, and then we'll go into Sutton. So, Crystal, we see Crystal, and, you know, she and Rob, they're getting ready for dinner with their children, and she lets us know that Rob, he had a conversation with Sutton at the election party, and I guess he liked Sutton. You know what, Rob, you can like Sutton. Hey, that's you. Me and Crystal, I think me and Crystal are on the same page when it comes to Sutton. We don't see it from Miss Sutton. Like, it's just something about Sutton that I don't garner authenticity from Sutton. I know everybody pretty much goes up for Sutton. I don't. I'm just still not one of those people. She just doesn't give me. I didn't like her last season. I still don't like her this season. So Crystal said, yeah, you know, Sutton was on her best behavior. And, you know, what's his name? Rob. He tells Crystal that he's surprised that she mentioned to the ladies at the table that she had battled with bulimia. And it was in this moment that I really felt bad for Crystal, because Crystal started explaining her story. She said she always felt like she was the chubby one. And the pictures that they showed of her, I'm like, I don't see chubby anywhere. She was talking about the fact that, you know, growing up, she wanted to be quote-unquote normal. And for her, normal was blonde, blonde hair, blue eyes. Colonizers. You know, so it's really interesting that people of different ethnicities still try to, you know, even when you have a, it's like, I don't want to explain it. Like within the African American community, we do things that'll get us closer to white. You know, light is right. You know, people don't want to be dark. The funny thing for me is when it comes to black African Americans or anybody that has a darker skin tone, we sometimes don't want to be the darker skin tone. But when you look at these white men and white women, what is the one thing that they do? They go get tans so that they can be what? Darker. That's one thing that I always found quite fascinating is that, you know, in the Asian cultures, you know, Asian, Hispanic, and even the black community, where we have an issue with, you know, darker skin tones, but whereas white people, they go tanning to get the glow that we have as, you know, people who have melanated skin. They go to the tanning salons. Really interesting. Really interesting how that happens. Huh? It's not okay for us to have dark skin, but let's for instance use the Kardashians. Like, look at them. They have completely erased their ethnicity. Completely. They've now, you know, taken on things that were looked on upon negatively upon black people. You know, when Kim had those quote unquote Bo Derek braids, the big butts, all that stuff. But yeah, I'm glad that, you know, Sutton, of course, was in a good space with her life. But let's move on, you guys. All right, you guys, let's talk about Renna. Ain't really much with Renna. So Harry has made a garden, and honestly, that was a smart idea. If I had a house during the pandemic, if I was living in a house, you know, when the pandemic first started, I definitely would have gardened. Because, you know, at one point, there was, you know, it was, especially in my grocery store here, there was very little food on the shelves. So if you had a garden and stuff, hey, you had some of the stuff that you needed. You didn't have meats, but you definitely had fruits and vegetables to eat. So then Harry and Renna do a fire drill, and I was confused at first why they were doing the fire drill, but then I thought about it. I'm like, okay, the wildfires that happen out there in California every year, and I said, I'm guessing this must be the time of the season of the year for the wildfires. So it made sense to me. So then, you know, Renna is telling Harry that she had a conversation with Erica, and she said that Erica's doing good. I mean, what do you expect for her to say? She's doing bad? Of course she's going to say she's good. And then here is just reminiscent of his first divorce and his second divorce. His second divorce, he was just ready to get the shit over with at that point. You know, I always find it funny about Renna. If you guys ever notice, when Renna is in her interviews with the producers, I wish I could be like Renna. I do, in this sense, that Renna laughs at her own jokes. Like, if don't nobody laugh at Renna's jokes, Renna is gonna laugh at her own jokes. And I find, you know, I can appreciate that. Like, that's something that my friends always say, you got a bit of a dry sense of humor because you say funny things, but you don't laugh at it. I'm like, because I didn't find it funny. And not, sometimes when I say things that people find funny, it's like, I'm just, you know, speaking openly. But yeah, that's that. And then we're gonna move over and wrap up with Sutton. Alright, you guys, so let's wrap the episode up, and I think you guys may have heard the air. Like I said before, it's hot. I ain't trying to burn up doing this video. So let's talk about Sutton. So we see Sutton, so she and Garcelle, they went out car shopping for a Bentley. Child, if I had the money to buy a Bentley, I wouldn't. I still wouldn't buy a Bentley. Like, I just don't, I mean, I get it. When you get money, you want to do nice things for yourselves and buy nice things. But child, I just don't understand buying things that they depreciate. Me personally, I would be one of those people that you would see loaning cars. Even if I got the money, I'd be like, that's a loaner. Like, leasing. That's what it is. I'm leasing that vehicle. That ain't my car. But, you know, Garcelle asked, you know, how much is this car? $300,000. It sit right there on that lot. So then they both talk about Erica and the fact that they, you know, they haven't heard from her since she let them know that she's filing for divorce from Tom. Again, I don't know what y'all expecting. If I'm filing for divorce from my spouse of 21 years, I have to take the time to mourn that relationship. So, yeah, y'all ain't gonna hear from me for a while. So then we see Sunshine's at her store, and, you know, Kathy and Kyle, they come by. And they're talking about this party that Sutton is going to have. So it's going to be a Parisian-themed party. And I'm like, Parisian? I don't know why I kept thinking Persian. Because I kept thinking Persian. But I know that the woman was saying Parisian. But I kept thinking Persian. But, yeah, she's having a Parisian-themed party. So then Kathy asked the question, has anyone talked to Erica? And once again, no one has talked to Erica. But, I mean, like I said, what do they expect? A 21-year marriage gone. She's gonna have to, you know, she's probably staying to herself, and she's probably talking to the people that are closest to her, like maybe her son. Is her mother still? I think her mother is still alive. You know, her mother. I think people like that. So I mean, yeah. So then they say, "Do you think she's coming to your party?" And you know, Sutton was like, "I don't know." But then Sutton says, "They says, well, why don't you call her or text her?" So Sutton does text her. And then Erica did text back and say she was coming to the party. So then we see all the ladies as they're getting ready for the party. We see Kyle. She went over to Crystal's house. And Kyle wasn't listening to anything that Crystal was saying because she was focused on his purse that was on Crystal's table. What else? I don't forget what else happened. Whatever happened, it must not have been that important. So then we get to the party and, you know, Renna and Kyle show up. Renna and Kyle have the same exact dress on. This happened last season, right? Or was it season 9? When Renna and Erica had on that same pink dress. Was that season 9 or was it last season? I don't remember. But yeah, they had on the same dress. So then everyone has shown up to the party with the exception of Erica. And Garcelle said the same thing that I've been thinking for a while. I was thinking, but with all this legal stuff, I don't really think that Erica had much of a choice, because she was like, why don't she wait? And they were like, what do you mean, why don't she wait? I'm like, y'all gotta be dumb as crap. Do the math. Tom is 82. He's 80. So she's saying, why doesn't Erica wait until the man dies? Morbid, but that's exactly what Garcelle was saying. So then Garcelle also said, do you think that this was Erica's idea to file? And all the ladies said, oh, yes, I'm pretty sure it was Erica's idea to file. After hearing Garcelle say that, it got me thinking. It really got me thinking. Because it goes back to the hustler and the housewife. I wonder if Tom told Erica to file for a divorce from him to save herself. But see, that's stupid, though. Well, not necessarily, right? It might be a catch-22. Because, you know, when you're married, you have spousal privilege. Like, your spouse can't testify against you in the court of law. Huh. That's interesting to me. You get this car, I'm gonna whoop your ass. Just let you know that right about now. Watch how you park. Turn your wheel! My bad, y'all. This person was, like, literally close to my car. My bad, y'all. I didn't mean to yell on y'all ear like that. That's my bad. Where were we at? I don't know how Rocks, I don't know how anybody who comes in their car do it. I don't know how Rocks does it. I don't know how Erica does it. I don't know how anybody do it. Because I got terrible. I am road rage. You know what? Let me check and see if maybe I'm not on the line. I didn't think I was. Yeah, okay, so spouse, so it's gotta be catch 20, it's gotta be a hard one. Because I'm pretty sure he don't want anybody to go after Erica, but in the same realm, if she was still his wife, she wouldn't be able to testify against him. Oh, hello. You look good. Yeah. Oh, okay. So yeah, that, guys, that's it. Let me know what you guys think about the episode. And I get distracted easily. Let me know what you guys thought about the episode. Like this video. Leave your comments in the comment section below. Subscribe to the channel. And hit the notification bell button so you guys are aware when I drop anything else. Share this video. And until the next one, stay safe, you guys. Take care of yourselves. Remember, wash your hands, wear your mask, socially distance, you guys. If you guys choose not to wear a mask, wear a mask. Just be safe with whatever you're doing. Be blessed, you guys. And until the next one, I'll see you guys later. Bye, guys.